Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I just want to show you an example of constructing a confidence interval using the sample mean given the population standard deviation. So listed below are the birth weights in pounds of 10 babies born on April 27th at a local hospital. Construct a 99% confidence interval estimate of the mean birth weights of all babies, assuming the weights are normally distributed and that sigma or standard deviation is 0.95 pounds. So first of all, I have 10 different weights of babies for a day. What is the best point estimate of the mean of the population? The best point estimate is the sample mean. So the best estimate would be our sample mean. So we're going to use that, use a calculator or StatCrunch or something to find that mean. We're just going to add all those up and divide by 10, and we get 7.4. X bar is our sample mean. And mu down here in our answer is our population mean. That's what we're estimating, and we're using our sample mean to estimate our population mean. We are given this population standard deviation, so we'll be using normal distribution rather than a t-table. The area in two curves, so we have a 99% confidence, so we have 1 minus 0.99, which gives us 0.01. You can use technology to find the critical z-score that goes with 99%, or you maybe have that written down in your notes because we've looked at something like that before. I think we just did 95, yeah, we do 99, 90, 95, 99, so it's 2.575. If you weren't given 99, maybe you were given 97% or 92 for some weird, you know, just to see if you could do it, you can use technology and use inverse normal on the TI-36X Pro, or you can use StatCrunch to find that too. Margin of error is the critical score times the standard deviation over the square root of n. So our critical score value was 2.575. We were given that the standard deviation is 0.95, and we were talking about our n was 10 different births, so the square root of 10. And if you complete that calculation, you get 0.774. That's the margin of error. To find the interval, we take our sample mean and we add and subtract that to get our interval. So first on the left side, we subtract. So we have 7.4. That was that sample mean that we found, and we subtract this margin of error, and on the other side we take that same sample mean and we add the margin of error, and that gives us two values, 6.63 up to 8.17. And so what we're seeing, as we to interpret that, we would be saying that we are 99% confident that the actual mean birth weight of the population lies within our interval. And I did look it up. I think I can't remember now what it was, but it's something like 7.6 or something. It's pretty close to our estimate here, and it falls within this interval that we give here. Okay, doesn't mean every baby falls within that interval, right? We're talking about the mean or the average birth weight falls within that range. We know that there are outliers. There's outliers in our own sample. But this is where the mean birth weight lies. All right, have a fantastic day. And remember to